Now, I have a theory, and I'm not a medical doctor, so this is going to be a very generalized example. In the normal conditions, when you eat, food goes down your throat and into your stomach. As you digest the food, glucose is released into your bloodstream, goes all over your body, and insulin is released, I believe, by the pancreas. Processed by the liver, some of the glucose will turn into triglycerides, which will go through your bloodstream, and triglycerides are what we're looking for. And some of the glucose will be converted and stored as energy in the cells. If you're non-diabetic, your glucose level initially will rise, and then the insulin level will rise, and then the glucose level will start to drop as the insulin converts the glucose to triglycerides and also stores it as energy in your cells. An hour, a couple hours later, both your glucose and your triglycerides tapers off, and the normal level for glucose might be anywhere from like 90 to 120. Anything lower than that would be low glucose, and anything higher than that would be too high of glucose and you might be diabetic. The triglycerides should be anywhere from 0 to 130 to 200 or so. Well, let's just say 200. Anything that remains high above that when you're not eating is actually too high, and there might be an issue. Now, what my theory is even though I've fasted for 8 to 10 hours and my triglycerides should be under 200 and my glucose should be normal. Anyway, my glucose is normal because I know I'm not diabetic. I have a theory that as I'm sleeping and my throat closes off and I get no oxygen to my lungs, that my adrenal glands are releasing adrenaline or epinephrine into my bloodstream. Now, this would actually cause the liver to release a sudden flow of glucose into my blood. That happens for energy under stress. This glucose raises in my blood, causing the same thing that happens after I eat. That I have a sudden rush of insulin, and then it converts the glucose directly to triglycerides because the glucose storage in my cells is already full. So I have a sudden increase in triglycerides, a very high increase in triglycerides, in fact over 500. And that's my theory.
So after a normal night of sleep, I took out my triglyceride meter and tested my triglycerides. Just a simple poke of the finger, draw of blood, and let the machine test it. And the level came out a little higher than I expected, but it was still under 200. I'm going to do the same thing after sleeping and fasting without using any sleep apnea device to help me breathe and see what happens. Now here's the second day. I slept all night without any CPAP device, no assisting in breathing or anything like that. So I basically probably spent the whole night snoring and tossing and turning and not really falling into a deep sleep. But what I'm looking for is if my oxygen levels lowered enough to actually trigger the release of adrenaline or epinephrine to wake me up, which is what I believe is causing my tossing and turning, then I should have also had a release of glucose, and the high glucose throughout the whole night would have resulted in high triglycerides in the morning. Here's the result. I don't know. What do you think? Let me know what you think.